Okay, hello, my name is Antonio Odhiambo. I'd like just to give you a brief overview about my app called Gind. The name is not fixed, it is currently tentative. It's basically a one and only one social media app, and this concept came about 5 years ago. And I noticed that there are many social media apps that are trying to add more functionality to their apps. And I thought that it would be cool if you had an app that already had all that created in the first place. And I'll give you a good example. For example, if you're on YouTube and you'd like to communicate with someone, the easiest way would be to use Twitter. Or if you have a Twitter app and you'd like to explain something on video, you would probably do it on YouTube. So that's why Twitter increased the amount of video time they could watch, and then they added the streaming functionality, or rather, even monetization. And the same thing happened with YouTube, because YouTube was so much for videos, they had to add a functionality to communicate with the audience, so they had this thing where you had this community chat thing going on. So the idea is that each app is limited to its function, because back in the early 2000s, they assumed that was as far as they could go. But for us, what we can do is create an app which has all that in one. So when I look for Dave on YouTube, I know the same Dave will be on Twitter. I will be guessing. What that means is that on Pinterest, we'll have all the functionality of you know, watching videos, posting, selling your stuff, streaming, all in one app. And this will be a function, not added. It won't be like an aggregate combined software. It will be just one app with all these facilities. To continue more, to explain a bit. So one of the advantages that the app will have will be that the individual will be able to pick exactly what they need to cater to their needs. So for example, if you wanted to tweet posts, you could check that. If you want to do videos, you can do that. If you want to monetize, you can do that. If you want to sell, you can ignore everything else. So what will happen is you'll be able to customize each and every need depending on your desires in the app. So just to jump straight in, the app will basically look like this. This is the app icon. As I said, the design can change, and this will be the login. So you just log in into the app, and then in the app, this will be basically how it will look like. And this specifically is a section for posting messages or tweets or, you know, posts. So on the left side, on the left bar, you'll have the functionality. So this will be social, this is maybe videos, this will be maybe news, and this will be buying and selling. So on the left side, you have customizable scrollable tabs. And then as you scroll down, you'll have an option where you can select the platform of choice, as I said before. So depending on your needs. So maybe you'd need more social media stuff, like posting and commenting with friends and family, and less of buying and selling, because you're not big in that, so you uncheck that. So basically, this list becomes defines what you'll be using the app for. And whoever wants to use it in a different way will just activate what they need. So it will be modeled, it will be created in a module format. So whatever you need, you'll add. Whatever you don't want, you can get rid of. And this works also both ways for the developer as well, because we can also add more stuff. So it won't look strange if we add something else onto the function of the app without it looking weird. Like, for example, the way Twitter added, you know, streaming or monetization, or the way YouTube added video and chat. looks normal, but that would be probably as far as this app can go. Or this would be video and streaming, or would be as far as Twitter could go. But if you added other functionalities to the app, it would just be weird. So we're just taking all these things, and this is just two apps. You could also have a functionality for like giving your contact, having your official contacts like LinkedIn. You could have, you know, selling stuff like Shopify, you know, stuff like that. The list is endless. Basically, it's just trying to make your life much easier and trying to make your browsing online much easier and much faster. So, as I said before, this would be, you click on this tab, you'd come on the timeline tab, so you'd post anything you want, your photos, your experiences, your videos, just like an ordinary social media app. If you click on the video section, you would go to where the people have posted videos. So the people within the app have posted the videos. Same for here. So this is guys within the app who posted the social media app. And this is people who posted videos. So those who are interested in watching videos, they would be watching this video. And then the third place is, of course, you know, news and other stuff which you would like to add. And then the third section would be maybe if you want to sell or buy products, you'd have a tab which would be specific to selling your products. Now, what is cool about this app is you can have, so instead of having just one platform to target your audience to sell your product or service, you'd have a combination of up to 10 apps. So you can put your ads within this section for the timeline, for targeting an audience, or in the video section, or in the news section, or you could just specifically put it only to your buying and selling section. So you know that all the other places where you'll be doing your browsing, you'll be on your social media stuff will be clean out of ads. So you'll just be having, you'll be knowing that maybe ads will be on. It just depends on how we set it up and customize it. But that would be the basic idea of functions.